from heaven you came running. There was mercy in your eyes to fulfill the law and prophets. To a virgin came the word from a throne of endless glory to a cradle.
Praise the Lord. Thank you for joining me in the online Christian service with the Impact Christian Church this morning. It's a wonderful day today, and today is the last Sunday of this year. Can't believe it, time flies by so fast. It feels like just yesterday we started our first lockdown, but here we are on the last Sunday of 2020. I know it has been a challenging year, but I'd like to share a message from God's Word this morning, which I want to title the message today, God with Us. which I'll take the which is taken from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 1, verse 23. It says, "Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel," which is translated, "God with us." Praise the Lord. Before we move on, let us just bow our heart in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you so much for this wonderful time. Thank you for your faithfulness throughout the year, and I give you praise. And help me, Lord, to share your word in simplicity so that we can be encouraged and be drawn closer to you more than ever before. Lord, I thank you so much. I commit myself to you in Jesus' name. For your own glory, I pray. Amen. Well, on this last Sunday of 2020, I cannot think of any other scripture that is so appropriate to share with you this morning but the one that we just read a while ago, Matthew chapter 1, verse 23, "God with us." Actually, this scripture is a continuation or taken from the message that I shared last time about the birth of Christ when we were celebrating Christmas. However, I feel that this message is so appropriate because we are going to enter a new year as well. And as we are coming into an end of this year and getting ready to enter the new year of 2021, I know that some of us may feel uncertain, anxious, or maybe fearful of what will happen next year. Of course, this year has been a challenging and unprecedented year where all of us has been affected in many, many areas, politically, socially, and economically as well. Yet in the midst of all this, as God's people, we need to always remember that God is still in control. God is still on the throne, and He never leaves us alone. So please allow me this morning to share with you some points of God with us that are worth pondering and meditating on, which I believe will empower us to face the coming year as well. First of all, God with us means that the presence of God in us, for those who've accepted Him, will give us power to face the future victoriously. Psalm chapter 60, verse 12 says, "Through our God we will do valiantly, for it is He who shall tread down our enemies." It's with God that we will face our future, and we will face it victoriously. Listen to this wonderful testimony of a couple named Anita and Ronnie Smith. As a couple, they went to Libya to do some good works there, but a tragedy happened to them. Anita and her husband Ronnie moved to Libya because they said, "We saw the suffering of the Libyan people, but we also saw your hope, and we wanted to partner with you to build a better future," Anita said in a letter published on virgenetwork.org. Ronnie was a chemistry teacher in Benghazi school. On December 5th, 2013, something terrible happened. That on that day, it all ended during Ronnie's morning jog when he was shot and killed by an unknown gunman. In Anita's letter, she addressed her husband's attacker saying, "I love you and forgive you. How could I not? For Jesus taught us to love our enemies and not to kill them or seek revenge." My dear friends, what a powerful testimony that with God with His presence in us, we can face the future victoriously. We don't know what would happen, what may happen, what is going to happen. We do not know. But we know that with Him, we can have victory in every challenges of life. The second point that I want you to ponder and think of is that the promise of God with us, His indwelling presence, give us confidence of our future. Well, there is a very well-known scripture that many of you know in Jeremiah 29, verse 11. For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, says the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope. We may not know, my friend, what will happen in the future. But we know who holds our future. Hallelujah. The God who lives in us gives us the assurance that He will always be with us throughout everything that we will face. So with this thought, we can rest assured that whatever may happen, it will be for our own good, because God is with us. And in everything, God is working out His purposes in us. This is the kind of hope that will never disappoint us. Hallelujah. The third point that I want to share with you is that God's presence, God with us, means that His presence gives us genuine peace. In Mark chapter 4, verse 39, it says, when the disciples were going through the storms, Jesus said, "Peace, be still." Jesus said this when all the disciples were afraid, while the boat was sinking, the storms was coming, and they were not knowing what to do at all. Jesus gives us the genuine, unshakable peace in the midst of any storms that we might be facing in the future. This genuine peace is threefold. First, it's the peace with God. In Romans 5, verse 1 says that, therefore, having been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. And the second is the peace from God. It's 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 3. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. And thirdly, this peace is the peace of God. Hallelujah. Chapter 4, verse 7 of the book of Philippians. Philippians 4, 7 says, the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. This is the kind of peace that we will have, the promise of God with us. The peace that is not dependent on anything that is going on around us, but it's the peace of God that gives us strength and power to overcome and have victory. Hallelujah. The fourth thing that I want you to think of about God with us is that His presence, His being with us, gives us the unspeakable and unshakable joy. Philippians chapter 4, verse 4 says, rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Nehemiah chapter 8, verse 10 says that the joy of the Lord is your strength. Hallelujah. My dear friends, regardless of any situations that you are going through right now, or maybe we are going to be going through next year, we will always be strong and encouraged, because Christ in us gives us that strength by His Holy Spirit. And that strength produces joy in us, because joy gives you strength It gives you enthusiasm to do the things that God has wanted us to do. Even Jesus, when he was going through that suffering, he had his mind on the joy that was set before him. In Hebrews chapter 12, verse 12, it says, just like Jesus who endured the cross, because of the joy that was set before him, he endured the suffering. If Jesus could do it, he will give us the same joy to give us strength to go through anything that we might be going through next year. Hallelujah. No matter what we will be facing, we can say that Jesus is with me and in me. Because my joy is not dependent on my circumstances, but dependent on the unceasing power and supply of God's joy. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Remember that the joy of the Lord is our strength. Praise the Lord. The fifth point that I want to share with you is this, that the presence of God means that God with us means that we can live in the abundant grace and love of our Lord Jesus Christ. John chapter 10 verse 10 says that Jesus said, I come that you may have life and have it more abundantly. This amazing truth must be always in our minds, because remember that Jesus has saved us not just to go to heaven, but to experience his life here and his abundant life here. Not just talking in terms of material things, but more than that, I believe it's the abundant life in Christ Jesus, where the abundant supply, the abundant reservoir of peace, joy, love, that gives us strength and power to live an overcoming life, to allow God to move and manifest through our lives. Hallelujah. Because my friend, we need to understand that essentially everything happens, and all that we have today is because of his grace, because of God's mercy and God's love. And the fact that we are here today is the proof of God's loving kindness. Hallelujah. We are here today because of his grace and mercy, and therefore we can say with so much confidence that my future is bright because my life is in his hands and he never leaves me. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. This is our confidence, my friend, that God with us, his presence with us, gives us joy, peace, hope that never disappoints us. In closing, let me read Colossians chapter 2, verses 6 and 7. It says, as you therefore have received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk in him, rooted and built up in him, and established in the faith as you have been taught, abounding in it with thanksgiving. Hallelujah. It's so crucial to understand this, to continue being rooted and grounded in the love of God. Continue to seek God inwardly, to seek his presence that lives in us. As the scripture says, God with us, he is with us, he dwells in you, he lives in you. Colossians chapter 3 says that our life is hidden in Christ. Hallelujah. So let me encourage you to nourish his indwelling presence every day by giving yourself daily to the Lord, in prayer, in the Word of God, of course, and always trying to focus on the Lord in everything you do. And secondly, by having a consistent devotional time with the Lord every day. It's so important to set aside a time to pray and just seek His face in praise and worship, in the reading of God's Word. And of course, the last thing to do, the last step that I can share with you to nourish the indwelling presence of God is by taking time to praise and worship the Lord at all times. Hallelujah. Just like King David says in Psalm chapter 34, he says this, "I will bless the Lord at all times, and His praise shall continually be in my mouth." Oh, praise the Lord. As we are ending this year, we can be confident and be sure that God is with us. And yes, we will also be ready to enter the new year with that kind of assurance that God is with us and never leaves us alone. Praise the Lord. Let us bow our hearts in prayer. Dear Lord, I thank You so much for the truth of Your words, that Your name is called Emmanuel, God with us, which means You live in us when we accept You as our Lord and Savior in our lives. Dear Jesus, thank You so much for Your presence right now. I pray that for everyone who is listening, who is watching right now, Lord, heal those who are sick. Comfort those who are sad. And restore those who are weak right now, in the name of Jesus. Thank You, Father. I give You praise, glory, and honor. In Jesus' name, amen.
Redemption. What started in a manger ended in an empty grave. Oh, I know that hope has a name, Emmanuel, the light of the world, who broke through the darkness. Oh, hail the King, if You're searching, if you need healing, He's where you find it. Lay down your burdens and breathe in forgiveness. And if you need freedom, yeah, He's where you find it.
Praise the Lord. I hope that you're blessed by the Word of God this morning. Remember that God is with us. He'll never leave us alone. Today, is to prove that God's faithfulness never ends. Let us close our online service this morning, our last online service this year, in prayer. Dear Lord, I thank you so much for your word. I pray that once again, whatever we are going through and whatever we may be going through in the future, help us to believe and understand that you are with us because you live in us as we have accepted you as our Lord and Savior. Lord, I thank you so much. I pray that your blessings will be upon your people right now, that you will strengthen them when they're weak, you heal them when they're sick, and yes, Lord, you encourage them when they're discouraged, and give them victory in any challenges that they're going through. So, Lord, I pray right now, may your peace fill the hearts of your people, and the love of Jesus Christ always continually refreshes and renews us every day in the fellowship of your Holy Spirit to become living witnesses from now until you come again. Maranatha, everyone who loves the Lord says, Amen.